स्मृति
पुराणानां
आलयं
करुणालयं
नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं। श्लोक नंबर 158 उपदेश शास्त्री। The distinction is being made between intellect, perception by the intellect and perception by the self. Okay, how they are different? The self is the sakshi or the witness or pure consciousness is the self. Intellect is the instrument. There is a difference in the way they function. The intellect functions in the time and space. Any action by the intellect involves time sequencing. Whereas the self is beyond time and space, there is no time sequencing at all. Okay? There is no concept of time and space in self. So, self, the light of the self, Atma Jyoti, awareness, is lighting up everything. From the self perspective, there is nothing else. So there is nothing else is lighting up. It's only light is there from the perspective of the Atma. Okay? That's called light of the self, Atma Jyoti. From the perspective of the self, only awareness is there. There is nothing to be aware of because there is nothing else. But that awareness falls on the intellect and intellect becomes animated. And this animation of the intellect is called Chidabhasa or reflected consciousness. In that Chidabhasa, the intellect operates. While intellect operates, it goes through a sequential process. It doesn't go through a total awareness process. Sequential means first it will look through sense organs, it will look at the object. So it takes the form of the object. Then it recognizes the object from memory. Then says, oh, I like this, I don't like this. So all these are happening in a sequence, not simultaneously. From the perspective of the Atma, there is nothing called time, nothing called space, there is nothing called objects. Atma is like a light. The self is like a light. That light is there everywhere. And what is that light? Light of knowingness, knowing ability. From the perspective of the self, there is nothing to know. From the perspective of the intellect, there is something to know because it is going into sequence. Okay, so this is the, there is a difference between the perception or knowing by the intellect and the self. So we should not confuse the self with the intellect. Okay? When you say, I know a flower. Who knows the flower? The knowledge is happening in the intellect. Okay? Because knowing of the flower has changed the status of not knowing. From not knowing to knowing, the status has changed. But no status change takes place in the Atma, the self. The Atma doesn't undergo any changes. So what is undergoing changes is the intellect. Then what is the role of Atma here? The role of the Atma is it graces the intellect, it gives the power to the intellect to operate. And the power of knowingness for the intellect comes from the Atma. But Atma, the self itself doesn't know, undergo any changes. Like the electricity passes through the bulb glows. Electricity doesn't glow. Electricity only gives the power for the bulb to glow. Like that, Atma, the self, gives the power for the intellect to operate. The power of knowing ability. The intellectual, the power of intellect can be used only in the time and space in a sequence. Whereas the self is the light. Through the intellect, it eliminates the body, it eliminates the world also. Awareness spreads throughout the world also. But from the self point of view, there's nothing to be aware of. From the intellect point of view, I know, there's something to be known. This is the difference.